start up my dually. That's a loose connection or what? You can hear it clicking over here big time. Tight, it's just corroded. I guess I need my Jeep to jump it. Maybe I should plug in my battery charger. Hold on. So, as you heard, my battery has been doing that. I haven't been driving this much. But anyway, it's pretty corroded. I have two batteries on this. Don't know much about these. I guess I should put some water, distilled water in it. But yeah, it's pretty corroded, so that definitely could be my problem. All right, so let's undo them and reconnect them, clean them up. I got a battery cleaning tool I've had for 25 years. Good time to use it. Alright, so you always disconnect your negative first, but this has, these are connected, so I need to undo both, I think. That one came off pretty easy. Let's do the other one. Okay, so now we have no power going through. I'm gonna do this one first. Positive off. Put my gloves on. Definitely need to pop the cover off here and this one could be low on water and it's cold and it's been sitting. Boy, these are little screws holding this on. Very corroded. Actually, I should clean this up while I have it. It's a snap. This whole cover comes off. Ugh. I gotta go change my, I got my favorite shirt on. Alright, I just unsnapped the cap, the cover. So, I'm going to check my water here. See, it's low. Yep, low. Okay, I need to go get some distilled water. Be back. Okay, got the caps off. This battery is much better than that one. That one's got lower cells in it, but top it off. This is never easy to do. Probably should, you know what? Let me go get a measuring cup. Alright, we're going to use a measuring device here. Something with a spout on it. But I really don't need a lot. Distilled water. Guess it was lower than I thought. This ought to help my battery. So you want it to the bottom of the little opening here. Right. Alright, now we get to use our battery cleaner. This just cleans the, takes off the corrosion and gives you a good put it on the back of the camper. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So what you do is you put it on and turn it. And that's how you get fresh threads, like as you can see. goes up in the cable. Much better. I see there's a positive and a negative. They're different sized posts. Much better. These are short cables. Boy, look at the blue corrosion coming off of this. No wonder I'm getting a crappy connection. Sometimes you can use a knife too. All right, much better. Let's do the other side and then we'll connect the negative and then the positive. Alright, first we're going to do some, let me get another paper towel before I do that, actually. Alright, get all that dirt. So it doesn't go in. Yeah, these two, these are really low compared to the other one. So. I should have did this a couple weeks ago when I first noticed it. Starting funny. Much better. Much better. All right. Let's just fill this one up. All right. Now we got full batteries. See, that's splatting. Hopefully that's not acid. think it's just water. All right. A 1,000 cranking amps on this. Boy, that corrosion. Could use Coca-Cola, but I don't have any because I don't drink that stuff. See, a wire brush does it too. Negative. See how that just cleans it right up? Positive. Right. Boy, this positive over here is really corroded. Wow. right. Hopefully this will help. So, hook up my positive now. That on, get my little ratchet. Oops. My 1/4-inch drive ratchet. It's an 8mm. Funny, it's like, why is it metric? I'm finding a lot of things are metric. Just a screw. Which one's better, a long one or a short one? Nice and tight. Now we're going to do the positive on this side. And then we hook up the negative. As long as the negatives aren't touching, it's an incomplete circuit. Completely safe. Nice and tight. All right. Now I'm going to hook up the negative on this side. I think I want to run a little bit. All right, a little bit of a spark. Nice and tight. All right. Now we can hook up the negative on this side. We have a complete circuit. right. Cool. All done. Now we'll see if it starts. Might have to run to charge, but hopefully it'll start. Glad I have this in the sun today. It's kind of cold, but it's nice. Feels good in the sun. Take these gloves off. All right, let's try it out. See if it's not. See if it starts. So let me go get my jumper cables so I hook my Jeep up. So you always hook up your positive first, your negative second. Actually, let me hook up the good battery first, you think? Seriously? Seriously? I started my Jeep. Sorry about the weed, the blower. my Jeep. That much of a draw, I might have to rev it up. Mary Lou's gonna rev it up a little. Put the charger on it. Okay, so my neighbor is getting their lawn mowed, so that's great. So I got my battery hooked up to my charger, got a smart charger, and it's charging. So I'll let it do its thing and I'll put it on the other one later or try it again, I don't know. But it's definitely not starting. But all that new water I put in has to react. So I'll see. Give it some time and check back on it. That means it's charging. That's good. All right. Let's see. I don't know what time it is, but I'll check back in an hour. All right, I got my truck started after I charged it.